Welcome to Cool Explorations.
Remember, guys, if you like these videos, just hit that little like button and subscribe to there so you don't miss any of the future videos.
Canada claims to have free speech, freedom of religion, and freedom of the press. But does it? I would say no. Religions in Canada are told how they can and can't operate, who they have to marry, and where they can share or celebrate their beliefs is limited unless you believe in Islam. Free speech is actually not allowed. It's just allowed as long as it does not offend even one single person. Good luck with that. Or it is in line with what Trudeau has said. Otherwise, you are forced to keep your mouth shut. Freedom of the press is a complete joke. The lack of freedom of our press is what we will look at today. One way that Trudeau has dug in on his campaign against media that do not favor his personal image is to refuse them entry into political debates or events. All reporters are allowed to report on political events as long as you are a blogger or article writer. You are considered press, and as such, have a right to access political debates and political speeches. Rebel media tried to gain access to the federal debate prior to the election in 2019, but were denied access. Trudeau threw an injunction at them to prevent entry at the last possible minute on a Friday in hopes that rebel media would not be able to counter it in time. Thankfully, they were able to get their lawyer to get them an audience with the judge, who did not appreciate the dirty tactics by Trudeau and the Liberal Party, nor the fact that they were impeding on the rights of Canadians. The judge granted access to the debate for rebel media. Shortly after the election, Trudeau threw another one their way for the exact same thing, which makes no sense as the debate is already over, but he is trying to set a precedent for future events to bar them entry. Rebel media will be going to court once again to protect the rights of Canadians and the rights of reporters. All Canadian reporters deserve equal treatment by our government, not blatant favoritism towards media sources that the Liberals have bought and paid for. Trudeau also jokes about how he has bought the media's loyalty through his federal media buyout of $600 million. SpencerFernando.com quotes, "Trudeau outright says, we paid them $600 million to buy off the media in order to get good coverage." What outlets is he talking about? Well, CTV and CBC mainly, but Global and City TV were also included in that buyout, as well as some newspapers. Though these were not the only ones. The money that Trudeau claims we paid is not Liberal Party money, but Canadian taxpayer dollars. In other words, Trudeau has used our money to pay media outlets to spread liberal propaganda and anti-conservative lies. He is using them to run stories to distract the populace from his negative actions, his scandals, his thefts, his embarrassments. These are stories that media would normally jump all over, but now we see them glaze over these items, and they are not shared at all with the East, anything to do with the West. The media companies just make excuses for the Liberal government, and then anything Western story related gets it pretty much ignored or just a very brief blip on the Eastern news, which leads to further disconnect between our country, anger, frustration, and furthers the Western alienation. Meanwhile, he also uses our tax dollars to bar opposing news organizations who won't accept his bribes from being able to have access that they have right to. Sounds like a government with a lot of secrets and scandals to keep quiet about, and it sounds like that, as it is exactly what this is all about. Silence, censor, and protect our image. We live in a dictatorship, people. He also used has bought and paid for media to assist him in his campaign and hinder the efforts of opposition parties. Election interference that we will never see charges laid for. The fact is, though, that now we see media being arrested in Canada simply for doing their job and reporting. Yes, that is right, in Canada. In 2017, Hamilton police arrested two members of the press, threatening a third. One reporter was a freelance reporter, Dave Ritchie, who arrived before police tape went up. He set up his camera, then left it unattended for a minute while he grabbed new batteries. Then he came back and the police had illegally confiscated it, then arrested him for demanding his camera back. The officer called reporters scumbags, and then when Ritchie demanded his equipment back and argued with the officer, he was tackled to the ground and detained. Global reporter Jeremy Cohn was also arrested. Both were released shortly afterwards, but videos of the officer arresting them shows his anger and bitterness towards reporters. The arrests brought up a lot of concerns with freedom of the press groups. Constable Jeff Todorok now faces disciplinary charges for this incident. I would be very concerned about the precedent that this sets for the suppression of the media, especially when combined with the rebel media court case. Trudeau, just before the October 2019 election, paid Facebook $100,000. This money was used to exploit the private information of millions of Facebook users. This was supposed to be used to hire Christopher Wiley of Facebook. The government claims that the money was used to keep election interference off of Facebook. The problem is that election interference is a fairly ambiguous term, and from the looks of things the way they are now, it involved removing more conservative support posts. Currently, we see Facebook shadow banning and limiting posts that speak out against Trudeau and the Liberals. People have had their audience limited due to this manner of post, as well as having these posts removed. YouTube is joining in on that now as well, since they are owned by the same company, starting to remove anti-Trudeau posts and shutting down channels that they deem to be not profitable. This sounds like more of another censorship scandal that lines up with the silencing of reporters and buying off of news networks. Conspiracy theory or plausible theory? You tell me in the comments.
Remember to like and subscribe.